Well, in this video tutorial, we are going to do a totally different method. A totally updated method to be able to recover what is our device. Since it has a screen lock also with the forgotten Gmail account. What are we going to do to be able to recover our device? Well, let's see what the video tutorial is step by step until the end to be able to solve what is the problem of the account deletion of our device. The first thing we are going to do is connect to a Wi-Fi network. We are going to connect to any network. We connect and we are going to give it the tour, we connect. We are going to show you that our phone has a screen lock also with the forgotten Gmail account. These disk files are totally updated since it allows us to share. It also does not allow us to enter through Google Maps. It also does not allow us to download those notifications as we did. Before that we downloaded those notifications and from there we could enter. Since those functions are no longer working. So what are we going to do to be able to recover our phone? Well, let's go degrade our device. How are we going to do it? Well, everything we are going to explain it step by step. Where you will be able to download what the file is. Also where you go to what you have to do so that it lets you do the process correctly. We will click here where it says do not copy. Here we will see what the blocking of our device is, also what the Google account is. The Gmail account, well, telling you. Since we have seen that our device is totally blocked. The other thing that I also want to tell you is that we are going to use a software to be able to downgrade our phone. When we run that software, it will automatically be installed on our device, and from that way we will be able to recover our phone. But if you have to do as is, we are going to use what is a PC to be able to do this process. Before we run, what is that software? What we have to do is deactivate what is the antivirus. Temporarily to deactivate the antivirus temporarily so that that software does not recognize us as a virus. We already deactivated the antivirus so that that software recognizes us as a virus. Then we go to the APCEH. Well, we are going to go to what is our antivirus. We are going to go to our antivirus and we are going to deactivate our antivirus temporarily. We go here to antivirus. Then we are going to go down here. Here we are going to find the option that says manage settings. Then we deactivate the first option that appears here that says real-time protection. We deactivate that first option. Then we are going to what is to the browser and we are going to write DEIVIS. This is where we are going to be able to find all these files. Here you are going to write DEIVIS as it appears here on the screen, right? Ready. Then this option will appear that says ANDROIDETV DEIVIS. Either of the two options, you are going to select it. Then it will take you to what is our official page. When we are on our official page, we are going to tell you where you are going to be able to find those files. That software, as we can see here, we have several entries. Sorry, several totally different methods. You are going to be able to find it here. We are going to select this entry that says apps device or applications device. We are going to select that option. We are going to click, then it will take us to this section. Here we are going to go to the last options. We are going to look for the last option. The last one here we are going to be able to find. The software works for various models. Here are the models for which this process applies. The process applies to various models. Then, so that said, what we are going to do is delete, I say we are going to look for. The software, since what we downloaded, we are going to click here, we are going to extract it, we extract it. After we extract the software completely, what we're going to do is open that folder here. We're going to be able to find the option that says firmware. That's the option. We're going to select FIRF, then we're going to go down and we're going to find these options that say flash all. There are three options. You're going to go to their flash all, flash all.sh and flash all device. We're going to select this entry that says flash all. Nothing more. This one that we are marking here is the one we're going to select. After we mark that entry, what we're going to do is put our phone in recovery mode. Now what we have to do is turn it off. Turn it off, and then we're going to press the power button, volume down button at the same time. We're going to press those two buttons and it would take us to this section. Now we're going to leave it like that. We're just going to connect it. Connected, and now we're going to double click here on the option that says flash. We are going to double click on it. We click here where it says run. The program will appear here. We are not going to touch anything. We are going to let the program do its entire process. It will turn off and turn back on. Do not worry. Leave it as it appears here, and we are going to wait for the process to finish. When our phone completely restarts, then we are going to make the following configurations to be able to recover our device from there. That is why we always recommend watching the video tutorial step by step to the end, without skipping it, so that you do not miss any of these details. It is important not to skip it. You will not miss any of these details if you do not skip it. Now here our phone is going to restart. When it restarts, it is because our device has been degraded. Let's wait. That also works for the same models that appeared there in that reference. It is the same process. We are also going to continue updating other models also additionally to do the same. It is the same method, and you will also be able to recover it. Well, we wait, we are almost finished. Also, for those people who suddenly do not want to do this process, then in the description of the video and in the first fixed comment, we have a fully updated method. Here our phone has restarted. Now here we can disconnect it. We disconnect it, and now we are going to wait for our phone to start, and this always usually takes a while. When it restarts, it always usually takes several minutes. I am going to pause what is this video tutorial so as not to make it so long. Well, our phone has been correctly degraded. Then what we are going to do is go to what is, we are going to add the Wi-Fi networks. We add our Wi-Fi networks, and from here, where we will be able to enter to recover our phone, we click here where it says policy and privacy, ready. Now we are going to wait for it to take us to this section. Here we go to the last option, we click on the last option. Then we go down to the last options. We click here where it says Motorola.com support. Then it would take us to the next section. Here we are going to click on this profile that appears here. Then we click here where it says start with account of Google. Then we're going to click here where it says help down here. Then we're going to enter here. We're going to click here on these blue letters and click on the magnifying glass. Blue letters, magnifying glass, blue letters, magnifying glass, blue letters, magnifying glass, blue letters, magnifying glass. Going to get this share option. We're going to select message here. We're going to select the message that appears here. This message, yes or yes, we enter the message. We click where it says new message. Here we're going to write any number. We select that number. Here we delete everything. Here we're going to write www.youtube.com. We're going to click on send. Now we click here on upload. We click on it and we click on it here to the side. We give it to the side, and as you can see, it came up to update YouTube. But don't worry, if it came up to update YouTube, what you're going to do is turn it off. Turn it off when it's completely off. Press the button, press the power button. Volume down button at the same time, and we're going to enter recovery mode. We're going to reset our phone again. When we have completely formatted it, it will work again. We're going to look for the recovery option. We're going to select here where it says recovery. We're going to wait for it to start. We're going to look here where it says wipe data factory reset with power on. We select. Go down and give it again. We restart with power on. Now I'm going to pause the video while it restores. And we're going to focus again on where we started the session with YouTube. Well, we're back again. We're going to write now since it was completely reset. YouTube.com. We click on it. We're going to give it here in send. We click on it now. We're going to give it to the side. We give it do not allow. We give it the ball. As you can see, now YouTube worked for us. First it comes out outdated. We format it and then we do the same process again, and it will give you the option. Now you are going to click here where it says configuration. You are going to click here where it says accessibility. We enable this accessibility menu. We click the second option. We click here where it says device configuration. Here we are going to click where it says accessibility menu. We enable that accessibility menu between sold. It is already enabled. Now we go back, 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 back. Now we click here where it says about. We give it the option where it says policy and privacy, and it would take us to Google. We click here where it says use 50. We click here where it says no grace. Then what we are going to do is write DEIVIS. That is our official page. We go to search like this. That is how it is written. I am going to show you how to write it. Here it is. Write, end in double L. Now, then this second option will appear, which is our official page. You are going to click on our page, then it would take us to this section. You are going to click here, understood. Here you will be able to find other entries. You will go to the last options. Here you will be able to find this option that says IBISL apps. You will select that entry. Ready. Here you will be able to find other totally different entries. You will also be able to find other methods. Once you are here, you will go down and you will find this entry here that says Google Maps. You will click on that Google Maps option. This is to take us directly here to Google Maps. It will ask you for what a permission is, and you will click here where it says skip or skip. Then you will leave all that like that, and you will click on this profile that appears here. That little blue ball, you will click here on settings or configuration. Then you will click here on notifications, and you will enable these notifications that you will give the allow. Now you go back, You click here where it says improve location accuracy. You click accept and then you click here where it says accessibility settings. Enable this setting, ready. Now you click here where it says Google location settings. You're going to click here where it says see all. You're going to click these three dots, show system. And it lets us enable Google services, but don't worry. You're going to click here the magnifying glass that appeared there and you're going to write battery. Battery, you write battery. If it doesn't come out, you're going to delete letter by letter and it will come out. You're going to select the option that says battery usage of the applications or the apps. You're going to click on it. Then it will take you to this option and it will automatically point to you. Select that one. Go up and go to look for the Google Play services and you're going to disable those services. From Google Play is already disabled. Now what you're going to do is restart our phone. Restart it and here we will wait for our phone to restart completely. When our phone restarts completely to take us to the beginning, we are going to complete the process by watching the video tutorial step by step. Since our phone would have some errors. How do we correct these errors while watching the video until the end, because the screen would get stuck, so. If it doesn't get stuck, I'm going to explain how we are going to correct it, well here. It started, here it started, let's go back here, we will click here where it says continue offline, we click accept, we leave it like that here if you want. To do this process, do not have any SIM card entered in the phone and we leave it like that. Where it says wait a moment, we leave it there ready, we go back here, we connect to a Wi-Fi network, if not if you want, if you don't leave it like that, they will give you these 3 points, they will give it here where it says accessibility settings here. It will show you this profile that appears here, this magnifying glass, you go to select that LUP. Invites you are going to write the same battery. Write battery, you are going to delete letter by letter. You are going to select battery usage of the apps. You are going to click on it, then you are going to select this option. The same option that says battery usage of the apps, and you are going to search for the Google services. Here it is. You are going to enable those Google services. Enable it, you go back. Here you do not have to have any zinc entered. You are going to give it here where it says configure offline, we click on it. Configure, we give it accept, it took us to Google, we give it more, we give it accept, here we give it skip, we are not going to do anything. We give it here in now not. Next, we give it finish and I am going to show you the errors that we have left on our phone. This, that the screen will get stuck. It gets stuck. How do we correct this error? Well, we are going to lower the notifications, because to lower notifications it does work. We give it here in the little nut. We click on the little nut, we give it the last option where it says theme, we click on reset. Reset, here we are going to eliminate all these errors. We are going to click on delete all that data. When our phone restarts, we would have a phone free of any error.